How to figure an offset in your plumbing system. One thing that a lot of plumbers worry about whenever they're going down to Austin to take their plumbing exam is how to do the offset. So we've actually got something similar built here, and we're gonna show you how to figure that offset and how to get your piece right each and every time. So let's step over here, pull some measurements, and then see what we can do. Old school plumbers would literally stick a 45 on right here, eyeball it right here, and make their cut. And you know what, believe it or not, a lot of times they'll get it right. Now this piece here may get tweaked out of square just a little bit. This here may get pushed back just a little bit, a lot of different things. But there's a lot of old school plumbers that would look at it and eyeball it and pull a measurement right there and say, daggum, that measurement's right about, you know, 12 inches or so. All right, that's old school. What we're gonna do, we're gonna do something a little bit different. Let's set the fittings back down over here. And this is the way you wanna do this if you're taking your plumbing exam. If you wanna learn to work smarter, not harder, don't get me wrong, stove piping it like that, holding it up, you only need four arms. You need two to hold it, one to pull the tape measure, and another one to write it down with. An easier way though, is actually figure your center to center. Now the center to center on this is 12 inches, and I always like double checking. So we're gonna call that 12 inches. Makes it nice. If you didn't see what I did there, I double checked. I went center to center here and said, okay, 12 inches. Then what I did, put it on the outside of my pipe over here and come to the inside of this one. And if you line it up straight, I'm right at 12 inches again. So a lot of times it's easier if you're trying to measure center to center of a piece of pipe sticking up and where you're turning up, it might be easier just to go to the back side and then mark the back side of your pipe. Measuring outside to outside or outside to inside really is an easy way. Put your tape right up against it, come over your mark right there and realize that's where 12 inches is. So I've now measured it three different ways. I know 12 inches is right. So let's do the calculations and figure out exactly how long our travel piece needs to be, and then we can make our mark over here and know where to cut it.
This video is sponsored by Leak Pro. Go check out leak-pro.com.
So here's the two 45s. Now, what you're looking at is you're looking at center to center. And what we're trying to figure out is how long of a piece to cut right here. So here's center here, here's center here. So we need to figure out what the makeup is. And by looking at it this way, I'm gonna say it's about a 1/16 inch, but I wanna make sure I get it right. So I'm looking at the Charlotte Pipe and Foundry Company's layout sheet, PVC and ABS DWV fittings, and it calls 1.5 inches for makeup. So your A piece is 1.5 inches. So I probably, just cause that, I come back a little bit, so center's not right where that mold is, it's a hair behind it. Come back and measure there, and okay, I can see where the 1.5 inches is. So, 1.5 inches. So we need to remember that, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back to the glass board. We've got 12 inches. And we're gonna multiply by 1.41, since this is a 45 degree offset. And what we're gonna get is 16.92 inches. Now, for a plumber, that's gonna be close enough to tell you 17 inches, or you could say, okay, 16 and 15 sixteenths. And 16 and 15 sixteenths is actually gonna be closer to it. So we're gonna take 16, 15 sixteenths, and by looking at the sheet, we know that makeup from center to where the end of the pipe is gonna touch, the piece that you need to take off for your fittings is 1.5 inches on each one. So we're gonna subtract 3 inches. So 13 and 15 sixteenths is gonna be our travel piece. So we're gonna cut a piece that long, and then we're gonna figure out where to cut the pipe over here to line it up exactly where it is. So let's jump in here and cut a piece of pipe and then we'll go to the next stage. Now, I like to line the left side of my blade up right on the cut mark. That way I know this piece comes out exactly what I want. So now I've got my pipe cut. I'm gonna go ahead and file down the edge just a little bit. And me, I like to go ahead and hit the inside too, just to make sure there's not anything there that's gonna catch anything going through the pipe. All right, so now we've got our piece cut. Now, I know that top piece is movable. It'd be like a piece of going up through the roof for a flashing, so I know I can raise it up, but I also know that I cannot raise that high enough to make this piece fit. Now, we're not gonna glue this, but I do wanna go ahead and check or double check. So what I'm gonna do is lay it out where it's square right here on the table. So now I've got everything lined up, put a tape measure on it. And as you can see, we're right at 12 inches. Now, what I can also do at this point is understand that I've got makeup and an inch and a half there, and makeup on this is an inch. So I've got an inch of the hub, so 2.5 inches up is gonna be center, but if I take off that inch right there, so what I can do is measure from the bottom here, I need to come down 16 inches to have enough room to get this in. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna grab my pencil, and do you see what I'm doing here? I need this pipe to stick down, and if I put my tape right there where that's gonna be, it's gonna be 16 inches to the bottom of this hub. So I can allow however much room I wanna do, or I could measure and say, okay, I've got 12 and a half there, and then come down to 16 inches from there. But what I'd rather do is push this vent up through the roof. And I know we've got it sitting there, but I want to let it hang right there. That way I'm 12 inches above the roof. So I've got 2 7/16 inches, probably about 2.5 inches down below. So I'm gonna say, okay, I've got 2.5 inches of pipe right here. Then I'm gonna put my hub on. So from my hub up, we determined, because of the inch, I need 15 inches. So I'm gonna take my 2.5 inches, add 15 to it and give me 17.5 inches. So I'm gonna mark this at 17.5. Let me show you what I like to do too. I like to check and double check. If I cut this pipe right there, that's gonna put my fitting right there, and that's gonna put me right about where I wanted to be. I've got 1.5 inches above the pipe, 1 inch in it. So there's my 2.5 inches. So now all I gotta do is cut this pipe and put this together. And since it's in a tough spot, we really don't want to get the sawzall in there and possibly cut the other side of the sheetrock. I'm gonna take my wire cutter here, wrap around the pipe, and I'm gonna line it up right on my mark. Now that's where I want to be. So what I'm gonna do at this point is just start cutting. Oop, damn, it's sliding already. Now this is the piece that I cut. You see, not too bad. It's not perfect, but it's enough we can make it work. So remember what I talked about. This is gonna go up like a vent for a roof. So I'm gonna go ahead. Now, if I was in the field, I wouldn't put this one on first. I'd put the bottom on first. That way I could reach up here with a pair of pliers or something and turn it to make my final glue joint. But really, I'm just wanting to show y'all how this would all go together. Now, of course, I go up to the roof, loosen my riser clamp, bring it down. So once you get it all in, and like I said, we're not gonna glue this. This is a trainer. We use this for multiple things, and I don't want to just waste the fittings. But you measure your center to center, multiply by 1.41 like we did, subtract out your makeup that you can get right here. So to get these dimensions, you can actually get the Charlotte Pipe and Foundry cut sheet right here, or get their app, go to it, click on dimensional catalog, click on DWV PVC, it'll take you to it. You've got all the dimensions you need right there to get cuts like this done right each and every time. Now I'm doing this video for a 45 degree offset, multiplier 1.41. If you're a plumber or pipe fitter or welder, do you know what the multiplier is for 22 and a half degree offset? Now I'm not gonna tell you in this video, check out the comments and I'll come back in and tell whoever's right, they're right. This video was sponsored by Leak Pro, leak-pro.com. If you're a plumbing company owner or you're a plumber and you want to learn how to improve your skills, your services, the value you bring to your customers each and every day, go to leak-pro.com, check out the training, check out the equipment, and it'll help you take care of your customers better. If you're a plumber, do you use this? Do you use the app? Do you use the cut sheets? Or do you stovepipe it? Or do you just measure it out on the floor, write it down, and take it off that way? I'd be really interested, because before I started learning about the measurements and the multipliers, man, I was a great stovepiper. So I'd love to find out how you do it and what works best for you. And if you love this video, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, and if you know another plumber that needs to know stuff like this, do me a favor and share it with them just to see what they think.